Hey everybody, this is AlphaZero at your service. I'm going to do a review on the new episode of Magic Kaito 1412, Episode 5. Now, when I looked at this episode, I gotta say, it was pretty interesting and it had some themes that I found in my own eyes, you know. Now, I figured out that this episode got subbed out many minutes ago on a website, on certain websites I go to. The only reason why, like, I am having this late is because I took a nap, you know. I've been waking up early on Friday, like around like 5 o'clock, you know, and then I woke up today at 5:30 to watch Log Horizon and get the review going, you know, and it's pretty tiring, so I decided to take a little nap and rejuvenate get my energy going. Now, when I looked at this episode, I did have my enjoyable moment, so if anything else, I'd like to get started right now. Okay, we have like Kaito Kid going on another heist for a jewel, but so far like nothing much really happened. But there's a little audio thing from his father. Do you know the difference between like tricks and spells can be considered types of magic, but you see here they are completely different at heart. And I go like, hoo-wee! That right there, like when I hit like anything about his father mentioning a quote and later on, like, explains it, that's pretty much might be the theme of the episode, which I really enjoy, because, like, because sometimes, like, I just ignore it sometimes, but it does have some meaning behind it. Later, like, I think we have this new chick coming out of nowhere and says, like, who's the fairest of them all? And then the mirror says, you, except for one person. She breaks the glass and she says, who will be that person? Kaito Kid, he shows her. I go, holy dang, not bad. And then next day, it became February 14th, Valentine's Day, you know. But seeing how, like, things got a little, like, crazy here and there, you know. There's this new transfer student called, like, Koizumi Akako. And right now, like, a lot of boys got into chocolate, and then Kaito's like, hey, let me get some of your chocolate too, you know? But later on, like, it did not work. And after that, he goes like, okay, I don't need your chocolate. After he says, like, after she tells him to, like, to disband all the other chocolates, he goes like, then he uses a magic trick, and I go, not too bad, but yeah, you know? And by that time, like, I think, like, Kaito was teasing Aoko really badly, and later on, when he was looking for his handkerchief and went missing, but Koizumi, Akako or something, stole his handkerchief and tried to use a spell on him, you know? And therefore, like, his butler, or should I call him, I forgot his name, but all I know is, yeah, G. Konosuke? Well, I'm gonna call him Alfred, okay, for some reason. I don't know why. Tells him like there's different types of magic out there, you know. I mean, there are many colors of it, as you can see: black, white, blue, red. And Kaito's like, what the heck? And he goes onto another haste, but he gets hit by knockout gas, you know. And later on, he was about to be captured, but thanks to Koizumi Akako's interference, he manages to escape. And later, he ends up being flown in midair and meets Koizumi Akako, you know? And they actually had a little match. Well, not much of a match, but she's using magic on him to try to, like, get him to love him, you know, to eat this up. But thanks to Mother Nature, he manages to, like, be saved last minute. And that right there was just, like, pretty surprising, because I go, like, it takes a lot of luck to have that kind of thing right there, you know? And after that, Kaito teaches her, like, you know, like, that's what you witches do, but there are other ways to capture one's heart. So don't try using magic on people to capture their hearts, because you'll just be lonely in the end. And later on, I think she shed a tear, and she goes, like, once a witch sheds tears, she loses her magic. And Aoko and Kaito ends up playing snowball fighting, and then he accidentally hits Koizumi Akako, And she gets so mad, she builds a giant snowball and chases after Akako and Kaito, you know? And it just ends right there on a good comedic note, in my eyes, you know? So, I gotta say, pretty nice episode, you know? It had like a, maybe a cliche theme that everyone else knows, but I think it was enjoyable in the end. I mean, not to mention like he tells Akako like how you capture one's heart, you know? So don't try using magic and so forth. So Kaito Kid has a victory once again, so gotta give him some props about that. So if anything else, I shall see you guys, I think, in my World Trigger review. Give me about like 30 to 50 minutes at most, okay? So if anything else, I'll end it here. I'm AlphaZero people. Have a good day, and I'll see you in my World Trigger review, okay? Later. Peace out. Bye-bye.